Hello and welcome back to the cesspool. It's time to look at some profanity. So we're going to be taking a look at Night Trap for the Sega CD. And not particularly to talk about Night Trap, although I have some stuff to say. But more these early first edition Sega CD games that came in these cardboard boxes, because most Sega CD games we think about, they come in the blue, you know, tall boxes, similar dimensions to this, but tall, like fragile plastic cases. But these early ones actually came in cardboard, and even Night Trap. This is an early edition of Night Trap, which we'll have to talk a little bit about Night Trap here. This one is a bit rough around the edges, but the artwork is pretty well preserved here. And so Night Trap, this is a little bit of a weird game. It's an interesting game in video game history, of course. This game, along with Mortal Kombat and a few others, is basically what created the modern ESRB rating system for, you know, it's blood violence gore, not this game, but for the blood violence gore of Mortal Kombat and the, you know, sexual themes of this game. There's one scene that's not at all, it's 100% taken out of context, and it's not even, like, come on, the most sexual thing about this game is literally the cover. But that was enough in, you know, the mid-90s for Sega to get thrown under the bus by parents, Nintendo, and the U.S. government, which just shunned them to death and just destroyed them regarding their lack of a rating system for these more mature games, specifically on Genesis, and in this case, on the Sega CD with Night Trap and a couple other ones. This is literally a live-action movie. It's an interactable movie. It's very similar in its gameplay to something like Dragon's Lair or Space Ace. You know, those basically, it's a quick time event game. You have to figure out when's the right time to touch a, you know, a button, do this, that, whatever. Not all of them were like that. Obviously, we had, you know, Sonic CD is the hidden gem of the classic Sonic games, but a lot of them were a little wacky, and it's rare to find these cardboard box versions of these Sega CD games. They're just an oddity, honestly. And yes, Night Trap, famously, Howard Lincoln, during the Senate Council meetings, the U.S. Council meetings regarding the creation of the ESRB, Howard Lincoln of Nintendo said, "Night Trap will never be on a Nintendo system." And what do you know? They used this exact artwork and threw it on Switch along with PS4 and I believe Xbox as well. I'm not 100% sure. But yeah, this was released on a Nintendo system, even though you can literally see in the video, Howard Lincoln, president of Nintendo of America, said it would never happen. Look at that. But yes, they used this original artwork. I believe in the plastic case version, it did not have this artwork. I think it was a little different. It did not have this red border, though. That was an old Sega CD thing. You got the Sega CD logo, obviously. Welcome to the next level. Night Trap on the side, Sega CD logo on the back. Just talking about the next generation of video games on Sega CD. So yes, it's kind of showcasing that this is literally live action video. And yeah, that's just basically the whole game. And these games open a little bit weird. So from the top here, again, being very gentle, we have the manuals and related materials. There's another thing up here. Not. Maybe it's on the other side. This piece right here is actually stopping the disc case from sliding around. So we gotta open up the bottom, which is a little odd, and pull out this bad boy. And I could have sworn there's another thing in here. I suppose I am wrong. That is it. We get the manual, and we get the discs. Yes, two discs. This game took two discs. So you get disc one, disc two. They open in a standard jewel case design. Yeah, so they open on alternate ends. Doesn't say Sega CD, just two CD to designate that's two CD case. Literally just a generic case. There's nothing going on here. And that would sit in this cardboard box. Like, and you know what the thing is? You made this, so why are we not putting this here? Cut the manual in half, make it thicker, slip it around. PlayStation. I mean, this is what they did on the original PlayStation. But no, we have to have this giant-ass box made of cardboard that degrades over time. Big-ass manual talking about a game that, you know, nobody cares about. But yes, we have the, you know, this is kind of like the in-universe explanation of what's going on here. How to play the game and the Martin family. Enter to win $1,000 music CD sweepstakes. Wow. Lots of cool stuff on my Sega CD software. Okay. Hot new game info. Charters all month long. So yes, they were putting little ads in the back of there. But like, God, that would be terrible. I have to break my game manual to, yeah, the back of my manual here to send in my business reply to Sega CD registration. Wait, that's the okay. Little weird. But yes, this is the extent of the profanity in this game. We have burglars or these weird ass creatures sneaking in. This might have literally been the scene. I believe it was. And that's what it looked like. That's all you got. But that was enough for, you know, again, parents and the government to freak out and give us the ESRB, which, like, you know, okay. But no one even listens to it, so, you know, it's whatever. People were playing GTA 5 when they're like 6 or 7, so, you know, M for mature rating doesn't mean anything. And, you know, it just kind of ruined a mediocre game's chance of getting mediocre sales. I don't know. This game has kind of gotten a cult following because of that, but, like, its place in video game history is interesting, but it is not a, it's not a desirable game to play. Just like Sega CD is not a very desirable, format, but here we are taking a look at it. This is all there is to these early Sega CD games. Very similar to most other things, of the NES era. You get your cardboard box, your insert, with the game and your manual. That's it. And it's all held together by flimsy ass cardboard inserts inside the cardboard box. Except in this case, you get the plastic case. I honestly am a little surprised that we didn't see like a cardboard disc slip or something. But no, they went with the plastic because that's what Sega's always done with Genesis and with Master System and with Game Gear. Like, I don't, it's so weird. It's weird. And then they go back to plastic case, but then on the 32X, I don't want to get into it. Sega is just, they're doing some weird stuff. This is one of the weirder things, because this is one of the earlier cardboard box things that they did. And then they went back, and number one, they gave it a rating, and they put it in a plastic case. So, yes. Yeah, these are Sega CD games. I went on a little bit of a ramble there, but that's it. Thank you all so much for watching. Again, happy holidays, happy new year, merry Christmas if you celebrate. If you're watching these in order, I will see you tomorrow. But if you aren't, or this is in the distant future, I don't know when the next video will be, but I will see you guys then.